Wow. Usually it's like barren before I come on stage. Like, this is so good. This is so cool. Thank you so much. Welcome to our living room. This is our living room. We built this house 14 years ago to do these concerts. And we've been doing these concerts for 21 years almost now. This is concert number 980.
Wow.
Or 81. 981. Yeah, we're getting close to 1,000 now. Like, that's just the public concerts. Like, never mind the sessions and the, you know, private rentals and all that stuff. So we try to keep the house busy, you know?
Yeah.
In any case, we want to thank our sponsors, our season sponsors, our United Arts of Central Florida, Orange County Arts and Cultural Affairs, the State of Florida's State Department Division of Arts and Cultural Affairs, and ACS. So the ACS is the acoustic control system. It's a Dutch company. We have the only system of theirs in the South, and this is the only system of its kind in Florida. So right now you can't hear it much because we're in a small room, but even though your body is here in my living room, your ears are actually in the stage club in Hamburg in Germany. So there you go. Our sponsors for tonight are Skilo Engineering, the Schaller Group, and Park Ave CDs. And we are so lucky to have one of our board members here. Ellen Hurwitz is here. Thank you so much. If you are new to Timucua, we have a membership program. We hope that you will enjoy your experience today and that you will want to join our membership program, because there's several levels, but even at the lowest level, which is, I think it's about to go up to $120 a year, you get preferred seating, half off ticketed events, unlimited, that can pay for your membership in like inside of a month, and all access to archives of hundreds and hundreds of videos of past events, and other things like rebates at local businesses and these kinds of things. So we hope that you'll be inspired and that you'll want to join. And this is a pay what you want event, which means that it's not a fixed ticket price. It doesn't mean it's free. It means that you pay what you can, you pay what you want, which means that my gut feeling is that by the end of the performance today, you're gonna feel so good. You're gonna feel like, you're gonna be like débordé, how do you say, like overflowing,
yes,
with feelings and with money.
Absolutely.
And you're gonna pour that money in that bowl in there, and that money is gonna go to the people on stage. So I hope that you do that so that we can support these. You know, this is so important. We have people here from Japan, from Europe, from all over the world, but we also have locally grown, you know, wonderful talent, and this is the case today. I don't know if you were all born here, but you all live here, right?
Yes.
And this is awesome. We have such good musicians, like musicianship and artists. It's incredible. So just to let you know a little bit our schedule, next weekend, all weekend, this is a run, this is very rare, we have The Women in Black. It's a play produced and directed by Jeremy Seegers. It's kind of like, you know, how you have Christmas in July. This is Halloween in June. So this is like a kind of a scary, suspenseful, whatever. It's like it's a ghost story. So, you know, instead of waiting till Halloween, you can have one next week. So those are ticketed events. You can go on timucua.com to figure out and to find out how much it is and when. It's a weird schedule, so check it out. I don't even remember. And then we have lots of great events in June, and take your fill in June because we're taking July off. We have to visit our moms in Canada, yeah, near the Arctic Circle, so we're gonna take July off. I'm gonna bring a computer because I'm gonna write some music, but I'm not replying to emails and nothing. I wanna take a break.
Good.
So, yeah. And my wife, who's right there, and she teaches piano, and she's been working so hard, she deserves a break, believe me. You know, this pandemic has been tough on a lot of people, but I can see, like, it's so hard on her, like, having to teach little kids remotely, it was so hard. Now she's pretty much back to real person, right? Yeah, pretty much. But anyways, I'm fully vaccinated. I don't know about you guys, but yeah. So if you're fully vaccinated while you're in here, you don't have to mask up. If you're not fully vaccinated, please mask up and protect the rest of the world and yourself. And please silence your cell phone and disable the flash. And then when you're done, after the first set, if you want to stay for the second set, I'm sure we can arrange something. We'll figure out a deal, yeah? But we still want you to go outside. We're going to sanitize the room to make, you know, to make sure that the next audience, it feels good and safe here. We do have two Biocide air filtration systems, very expensive. We invested in that in December to make sure that to keep you as safe as possible. So the air in here is cleaner than outside and it's safer than outside, but we want to clean the surfaces in between. Anything else I need to say? We are live streaming and I'm recording everything. This they're going to get videos for that. What's that? Yes, it is live stream. You can tell your family and friends. So, it's gonna be. You don't need to know the exact link. It's youtube.com/timuquaarts, just like it says there in one word. Oop. Oh, that's interesting.
No, you did it.
No, the lights went out, and that's something I need to check. I think the power went out. So, anyways, thank you so much, and please. Please put your hands together for April Brown and It's Complicated.
Yeah. Well, hello, everybody. How are you feeling? Happy Sunday on this wonderful 3-day weekend. Yes. I hope tomorrow is filled with a bunch of nothing for you. Hey. So I wrote these songs because love is a lot like a dance. And sometimes that dance is well choreographed and it's smooth like this. And sometimes it's a little awkward, a little stiff. Can anyone relate? There are some days where things just flow and the choreography and the beauty of love. But sometimes, hey, can you snap like this? Hey, come on, snap like this, everybody. Don't wanna miss my cue. Yeah, when we catch the groove, then I'll be grooving with you. Interlude right here, say, come on, hey. Oh, come on, I'm trying to catch the groove, yeah. Wanna miss my cue. Yeah, when we catch the groove. Yeah, I'll be grooving with you. Sing it with me right here. Say ooh, 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 ooh. Come on, say ooh, 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 ooh. If you're feeling it, you can say. Trying to catch the groove in love, yeah. Talk to Omar Shanse. And I'm a righty. And sometimes we knock knees when we dance. Sometimes I can't hear him and he can't hear me. But when we catch the groove, it's beautiful. Oh, I know our heart's been broken, hey. Come on. But maybe we left the door wide open, yeah. My name is April Brown. April Brown. And I'm so grateful to be here. Thank you so much, Timucua Arts Foundation, for having us. It's a joy, it's an honor to share my heart and my stories and my life through the art. And so, me and this crew right here, we recorded my second album, It's Complicated. We recorded live here in Orlando at Stark Lake Studios. And the album will be released later this month everywhere. I'm super excited, still have a little work to do on it. But the project tells a story, tells my love story, and I think it's really all of our love stories, that the falling in love, that part can sometimes be easy. The butterflies, the googly eyes, and the poetry and the letters and all of those things, yay. And it's so beautiful and it's so lovely and it's everything. It's really literally everything that the songs talk about, you know. But sometimes, the little things are the hardest things to do, yeah. Like listening. Sometimes it's so hard to do. Like talking when we need to, it's so hard to do. And though we're trying to find our unity and our harmony, sometimes we lose our way. The song can go a little sideways. 'Cause it's complicated. It's complicated. It's complicated, yeah. I wish I could show up with all the answers. Everybody wants to be the guru. But I don't have all the answers. Instead, I have way more questions than answers. I've been married 10 years. Still have more questions than answers. It's still a daily learning thing. So here's my story. Yes and no, yes and no. Back and forth, off and on we go. It's the broken code of broken homes. No devotion, just shame. Well, we might as well be done. But how can I love so sweet? Tell me. Turns out it's complicated. It's complicated, yeah.
But I know we'll find it every time.
It's complicated, oh. Here we go. To the bone, hot and cold, we run. Empty heart, empty soul, empty home. This house is not a home. Might as well be done, but how could a love so sweet? It's complicated. Bring me back to where we started. Sometimes we have to start over in love. Simple love before we were broken hearted.
I know we'll find it every time. Give me hope, complicated.
Give me all my hope. Yeah, 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 yeah. Simple love gets complicated. Everybody in right here say, love my simplicity, love my complexity. Take it slow. Oh, I'm in love with you, yeah. This ain't the honeymoon. It gets more confusing every day. Sometimes it's heaven sent. We get back to hell again. Kiss, then we make up on the way. I know love sometimes hurts. I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. Thank you. Thank you. Man, it seems like relationships, there should be like classes on it. Like in high school, in college, you should have to take like multi-level courses on relating with somebody, because the simple things can sometimes be so hard.
And so this next song asks the questions, what are we gonna do with all of our foolishness, all of our brokenness, like when we're faced with who we truly are? Because it's easy to point the fingers and be like, well, if you were just, you know. But it's much more difficult to take a look at yourself. Take a look at yourself and confront your mess. Hey, it's like somebody unscrewed the top of my head. And I'm walking around with no thoughts inside. It's like I'm stuck somewhere between alive and dead. And merely thinking about it, it takes me apart. It's like somebody unscrewed the top of my head. I'm walking around with no Oh, grief feels like a screwdriver to the head. And merely thinking about it, oh, it takes me apart. Crumbled them, took my feelings, walked on them, took my joy, ran off with it, and merely thinking about it, oh, it pulls me all apart. Absolute lowest, my most broken, oh, but it's in that place, oh, that the Lord spoke to me, said, I'm with you and I've got you. As long as we're living, we'll always be broken, and I know it, yeah. But as long as we're living on this side of heaven, then I want healing for my heart, yeah. As long as we're living, we'll always be a little bit broken, a little bit crazy.
Yeah.
Jordan Kelly on guitar, Rashad Gurley on drums. So, during that season of just absolute brokenness, I wrote in my journal, well, I just felt so overwhelmed emotionally, so supercharged up emotionally that I could not even process what was happening. You know, has anyone been there before? Which is almost, it's overload for the circuit board and you literally cannot think. And so that's where I scribbled that in my journal. It's like somebody unscrewed the top of my head. Like, there's nothing in there. And so during that season, what precipitated that was my husband and I were actually in talks of divorce. Yeah, the big D word. You know, you don't talk about divorce, you don't talk about death. You know, but those are realities of the life that we live, and that's part of our story. And at the time, I was very, very ashamed of that season that we walked through. But right now, I'm so grateful to be free. No shame, not afraid. So we walked through that season, we walked through that valley. But part of my process and part of my dealing with it was literally going home to my mom and daddy house in Pensacola, Florida. And, you know, I just packed up and took the kids and went to my mom's house. And we stayed there with my mom and daddy, you know, just to be loved on and grounded. And in a lot of ways, to be reminded of who you are. So that was my process. And I was called home, like something intuitively told me to go home. And as I reflected on that, I likened it to my journey, my relationship with God and with Christ. How sometimes I get far, 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 far from where I'm supposed to be. But I'm called home, called to His side. Felt again,
dripping like tangled up in sin.
Off again. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, I don't want to keep you in suspense. We didn't get divorced. Okay. We didn't get divorced. March 11th made 10 years for us. By the grace of God, we made it.
Yeah.
more fun than singing with people. So we're gonna teach you this part. I got distracted, I'm sorry. Sing, brother, say. So we're gonna sing your part. It's real easy. It's real easy. So if you're nervous about singing, just take a deep breath. And it goes, 1, 2, 3, Ernesto. Real easy, real easy. Wanna hear you sing, 1, 2, 3, say Ernesto. Joel Fowler on the keys. My key man. Sometimes it burns real hot. Fire and desire. Sometimes it burns real hot. I didn't write this song, but I learned recently that this song is by Anita Baker. Not Anita Baker, I'm sorry. Aretha. Aretha Franklin. So we'll do it for her and we'll do it for Adele. 'Cause love, it burns real hot. And it's bringing me out the dive. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare. The thoughts of your love remind me of us. I can't help thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they keep me breathless. Special about that place, even your emotions have an echo in some other space.
Maybe we're crazy.
a human.
No, you're not crazy, crazy, crazy. Though sometimes you might feel a little bit crazy. Possibly, possibly. You're gonna wish you never had buried, yeah. Tears are gonna fall, rolling in a deep bag. You're gonna wish you never had married. Tears are gonna fall, rolling in a deep bag.
At one time, got complicated, and we asked ourselves, what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? So we took our mess, we had to face our mess, we had to confront our mess, and then we had to face each other, and it was worth it, and it was worth it. Love is worth the fight. Thank you, thank you. Thanks, friend. So listen, I'm gonna tell on myself. I watched Divorce Court. I'm not really that proud of it. But listen, Divorce Court is incredibly edifying, okay? At first, it was just like kind of gossipy and weird, but I really get convicted when I'm listening to Judge Lynn render her verdict and give her advice to each couple, because typically they don't divorce. They just talk about each other and then make up at the end, like we tend to do. But she said something so simple, yet so profound, and I was like, that's it right there. That is it. That's a word, as some people say in some circles. She said to the man, grow up. And she said to the woman, shut up. And I was like, grow up, shut up, yeah. Simple. Some things are not worth fighting for, worth fighting for. But real love is worth the fight. Forever seems pretty far-fetched. Lifetime seems so short-lived. Oh, but if I had to roll the dice on any love, I'd take my chances on this. Help me say, ooh, 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 yeah. Stuff of which dreams are made. Oh, but if I had to put my money on anything, I'd put my money on you, babe. No, 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 no. Ooh, yeah. I'd put my money on you, baby. Ooh,
get broken all the time. Oh, what if I had to stake my heart on anything? I'd stake my heart on.
Come on, say,
we're gonna thank you one more time. We- to my left, Brother Marvin on the bass, say,
rolling down the bottom, yeah, yeah.
Make some noise for Marvin Burke, right there, right there, right there.
Holding down the bottom, so
offense, guys. And behind me, Jordan Kelly, Jordan Kelly. It makes no sense. Thank you.
Thank you. They make it easy. They make it very easy. So thank you so much for being here. Again, my name is April of aprilbrown.music. If you'd like to connect with me, you can find me on Instagram at aprilbrown.music. I have a band. We perform weddings, parties, whatever you have going on. Funerals, we do it all. Baby blessings, whatever you have going on, from a trio up to an eight-piece band, we do the most and we do it the best. Also, I write and sing and stuff. And these are my musical friends. Can you please make some more noise for them? Their dedication. Y'all are something else. They really make it easy. I don't have to worry. I don't have to worry about a thing. You can also check out my website, www.aprilbrown-music.com, or you can just go to IG and find the rest of that stuff. I'm on Facebook as well, for those of you who don't like IG. I know. I know how it goes. So thank you, thank you. I'd love to talk with you afterward if you have any questions or if you'd like to give feedback. I'd love to hear what you have to say about the show. So thank you. That's it.
Hydraulics, if you want that one.
That one looks good. Yeah, that ain't got no wrong with me, buddy.
For the second set, you want to switch it up?
Nah, I'm straight, bro.
You sure?
This, yeah. As long as I'm not in there forever, I don't keep this.
Thank you. This thing look, should get over the bottom. Right? This thing should fit in there. Right there. And then lift it like that. See what I'm saying?
All right, I'm gonna make it.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about?
I know.
What's his wife? Mike Day? Where he married that lady?
I don't know.
I have an answer. She's fucking good.
I didn't know that was her name. Mike Day? Uh-huh. Yeah. Divine?
Anthony?
Yeah.
Well, we're the fans. I don't want to. I'm just kidding.
No.
I'm
just kidding.
You can call me Gio. That is my name.
Gio.
What's your name?
Monica.
Awesome. Are you
a
or are you
a
sponsor?
Oh,
my God.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Hi everyone at home. All right, so it's you guys are gonna have a private concert, but in exchange, I'd like you to do something for me. Take your phone out right now, and post something. Tell your friends everywhere around the world to watch it online. YouTube.com/TimukwaArts, so we can get more than like the 7 people we have watching right now. We could get like 100 people, right? You guys are popular. Same thing for you guys.
I shared it.
Do the same thing. So watch it online. It's free, you know? It's free, but of course, for you guys watching at home, it's free, but it's not, right? They have to live. And so it would be great if you would contribute, and you can help by going to timukwa.com. You can donate, and then we'll give them the money. So thank you so much. And thank you for doing that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And feel free to post to your friends after the concert, hey, man, this was a great place. It was like, you guys should go there. Like, you know, let's make this a little bit less of a good kept secret,
yeah.
You know? All right. And while you have your phones out, when you're done posting about that, just make sure you silence it and then you disable your flash. You're welcome to take pictures, but with no flash, that would help a lot. Because I'm filming this and, you know, it looks better when there's not like flashing all over the place. Thank you so much. My name is Benoit Glazard. This is my living room. I built this place with my family to have these concerts in my house because that's what you do where I come from. So, no, but seriously, I come from Montreal and, you know, you could find any night of the year, you could find like, I don't know, 50, 60, 70 live things every night of the week, right? And when I moved here in 1998, I was the conductor for the Cirque du Soleil show, right? And our days off at the beginning of the run were Tuesday and Wednesday. So after a few months of not being able to find anything live, it's no longer the case. Orlando has a better scene now, yeah. But back then there was nothing in the middle of the week. So I said, well, let's have a concert at our house. And so we did that, and we thought it'd be a one-off, but people said, okay, when's the next one?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so once a month for a few months, then twice a month, then every week, and then now it's like twice a week or 3 times a week. So we try to keep it to that because I have like private sessions. I have a recording studio here and broadcast studio, so you know I have to make money, and the concerts don't make me any money, and so I have to rent the place out to make money. But anyways, thank you to our sponsors, our season sponsors, our United Arts of Central Florida, Orange County and the Florida State. And our tonight's sponsors are Park Ave CDs. We have Skilo Engineering and the Schaller Group. So actually, Jason is of the Schaller, Jason Schaller. He's on our board also. So, you saw the ads. All you need to have an ad on there, and I put the ads online as well. I run them online. And when I make the videos, I put little spots there for our sponsors. So you get a lot out of, you know, for your money, and it's $500 a year to get an ad. So we have 27 sponsors right now. If we got up to like 40, like amazing things would happen here, even more amazing things, because I could do it, right? More money brings joy for you guys. So thank you for helping. I have talked enough. Thank you so much. You're going to have to be boisterous and energetic. Oh, yeah, you can film, take pictures, or whatever you want. It's okay. Yeah, so here's April Brown, and It's Complicated.
Let's go. Hey, y'all. Happy Sunday on this 3-day weekend. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Man, it feels good to be here with you. That first show was live, and we're going to keep it live for you. Oh, yeah. Catch the groove, 'cause sometimes in love it's like a dance, yeah. And on a good day that dance is real smooth like this, and on a bad day it's an awkward, it's a slow dance, yeah. And my husband, he's a lefty and I'm a righty, and when we dance sometimes we knock knees, and that's really like a metaphor for love. Don't wanna miss my cue. Come on. called Catch the Groove, yeah. Catch the Groove, yeah. 'Cause my husband's a lefty and I'm a righty. And I noticed that when we dance, we knock knees. I'm like, I don't knock knees with nobody else when I dance. And that became a metaphor for our love, like this dance that we're trying to do, whether it's with your mom, your cousin, them, your best friends, your husband, your wife, your boyfriend, your coworkers. There's this dance that we do in love. And more specifically, this my album talks about romantic love, the butterflies, the googly eyes, the I can't live without you, the love poems, the letters, checking the Facebook and checking the IG just to see them, call them on the phone. Can I talk to you? I get so weak in the knees. You're always on my mind. It's all of those things that the love songs talk about. Caught up in the rapture of love, but sometimes it gets hard. Sometimes trying to do this dance, we want harmony, we want unity, but sometimes there's a little discord. Sometimes things don't come together, yeah. Is this complicated? It's complicated. It's complicated. The deeper you get into a relationship, it seems like things should become easier, right? But sometimes it gets a little more difficult. And this album is about that very thing, how simple love can get so complicated and things that should be crystal clear can be rather muddy. And everybody likes to show up with all the answers and be the guru, right? And be the lecturer. But that's not me. I don't have all the answers. So I'll just tell my story, yeah. Love grown old to the bone. Hiding cold, we run, ay. Broken code of broken homes. No devotion to shame. Well, we might as well be. But how could I love so sweet? Tell me.
Turn to a love so
bitter.
How could I love that bird so high? All of a sudden just
stop and well, it turns out it's complicated.
Bring me back to where we started. Oh, 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 simple love before we were broken hearted.
I know we'll find it every time.
Give me
that's
hope,
complicated.
Beyond my hope, yeah, 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 yeah. Simple love gets complicated. I love my simplicity, love my complexity.
Thank you.
Take it slow.
This time.
Thank you. So this song I wrote at the absolute lowest point in my adult life. It was 2 years ago. My husband and I were in divorce talks, like the big D word. People's eyes get big. You don't talk about divorce, you don't talk about death, you know. But those are realities, practical things that we have to grapple with. So we're in, I call them these divorce talks, but you know it wasn't that cool. It wasn't that cute, you know. So that's my label for it now. But at the time, I was just so emotionally overwhelmed, so overwrought. I couldn't even process what was happening. Have you been there before? Where the feelings, you're just feeling so much you can't even think. And in my journal at the time, I wrote down, it felt like somebody had unscrewed my head. Like they unscrewed the top of my head and just took everything out. And that's where the first line of this song comes from. And I asked the question, what we gonna do with our mess? Hey. It's like somebody unscrewed the top of my head. And I'm walking around with no thoughts inside. It's like I'm stuck somewhere between alive and dead. And merely thinking about it, oh, it takes me all apart. It's like somebody unscrewed the top of my head. I'm walking around with no thoughts inside. Oh, grief feels like a screwdriver to the head. Oh. And merely thinking about it, oh, it takes me apart. Feelings, walked on them, eh. Took my joy, ran off with it, eh. And merely thinking about it, oh, it takes me all apart. So what we gonna side of heaven, then I want healing from my heart. As long as we're living, we'll always be a little bit broken. And I know it, yeah. As long as we're living, on this side of heaven.
Yeah.
Kelly on guitar. Jordan Kelly again. So some seasons have way more questions than answers. Oh, so I don't want to keep you in suspense. We didn't get divorced. We're still married. March 11th is 10 years for us. Woo, by the grace of God. Seriously, by the skin of our teeth. Man, and so I remember during that time, I just felt compelled to go home, like literally to my mama house, my mama and daddy house in Pensacola, Florida. Pulled up, me and my kids, just spend some time with the people who know you best to get rooted again, to get grounded again in who I was. So at the time, I didn't really know why, but after getting some distance from it, I'm like, yeah, that was the best thing to do, to go home, wherever home is for you too. And so I was thinking about that and how going home was also like a metaphor for like my walk with God and my relationship with Christ, and how no matter how far, no matter how low, he loves me, yeah. And he says I can always felt again,
tripping like tangled up in sin,
off again, lost again, wandering, I searching for a new place to begin.
Thank you.
Carol Fowler. So yeah. So back then, I was like, okay, let's just never tell anybody. Let's not talk about it. You know, it's a great source of shame. Great, great source of shame. But at that time, I remember there were just like little reminders of God's love and little reminders of, you're good, girl. You're loved. You're good. Like, your world is being rocked, but you're good and I've got you. And so I remember I got to work really early one morning. And just life was a lot heavier than my bags, and I'm walking across the courtyard in the dark. And this coworker, he's an older gentleman. He's never touched me ever before. It wasn't weird. But he just looked at me and he hugged me. And I'm telling you, a simple hug. Like, he got off his golf cart and everything and hugged me. And there's something like a hug or a simple gesture of love to just simply remind you of who you are, that you are loved, that you're good. And there were so many moments like that. And I know it's a hug. It's so underwhelming. But again, this man who never, ever touched me, never hugged me, like in the 4 or 5 years I knew him, I guess he sensed that in that moment I needed something. And I believe that all those little moments like that were just like little reminders from heaven. Little reminders that I'm loved, yeah. Say, this is your love.
Your grace, deepest affection.
start from scratch, cause this whole building, it gets leaky sometimes.
These flesh and bones, this heart of stone, this tongue of lies. Pain, tears with pain, shed tears like rain, we torn and stained.
Sing. We love to sing. And we all like to play our individual instruments and do our own thing, but it's nothing like singing and playing together. It's nothing like that. And so, we're gonna give you a chance to sing. If that's all right, it's real easy. It goes one, two, three.
Burn us down.
That's all right. That's all right. It's just us. If you're nervous, take a deep breath.
One, two, three, say.
One more time, say.
One, two, three, say. Burn us down.
y'all do.
Fire and desire. It burns real hot. Fire and desire.
But that same passion that can burn so intensely, the ecstasy, the passion. Whew. Boy, that thing can turn. Whew. And we can so intensely hate each other, hurt each other.
And it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your shit there.
It's okay to go see somebody.
It's okay to cry sometimes. take your medicine, 'cause you know you're not crazy. No, you're not crazy. It turns out you're struggling and you're having a hard time, but it's alright. Bring it down, say, don't be shaken.
It's called Safe Bet. So I had a friend once. I felt like she was waiting on the perfect conditions to move forward. Like she had been dating this dude, like bought a house. She's like, I don't know if we're ready to get married, you know. And it occurred to me that sometimes we're waiting on the sure thing. But there is no sure thing. There's risk involved in everything, even the good things, even good marriages. Like, fortunately, by the grace of God, and the skin of my teeth, we have a good marriage today, but there's still risk involved. And I remember way back when, I was so insecure, I was like, why are you looking at her? Why are you speaking to her? Why are you so friendly? That was... But I knew my husband was friendly before I married him. And so I couldn't take his friendliness as an indicator of infidelity. That's just who he was. That's just who he was. And I was trying to control him. Like control him. If I could just get you to do what I want you to do, then you won't cheat on me, then you won't leave me. But it doesn't work like that. Control is not a very good mechanism for love. Love has to be free. Love can't be compulsory. Love does what love does. It's a safe bet. Seems pretty far-fetched. Lifetime seems so short-lived. Oh, but if I had to roll the dice on any love, I'd take my chances on this. Help me say, stuff of which dreams are made. Oh, but if I
put my money on anything. I'd put my money on a love like this. Get broken all the time. Oh, but if I had to stake my heart on anything, I'd stake my heart on you, baby. Say, oh, we can make it, baby. Oh,
we can make it, baby.
Oh, we can make it.
Thank you.
make some noise for the ladies. We got China all the way from the UK.
Like poetry.
And to my left, we have Kyla the soprano.
We can make it, baby. Yeah. We can make it, make it, make it, make it, make it. Oh.
For allowing me to share a little bit of my life with you, share these moments with you. It's a 3-day weekend. Hey. Don't work so hard.